All right, scenario. You've got a softbox that you're using for lighting your photos or your video, and you want to enhance that lighting just a little bit and direct where that lighting is going a little bit more. A grid is a perfect solution for this. This is going to push all that light forward instead of it just spewing out all over the place. I've got a couple of these cheap softboxes that I picked up off Amazon when I first started to really get into photo and video work. And even though I'm not really planning on using these lights much anymore, I'm still going to need them here and there. I'm in the middle of upgrading all my gear, so while I'm doing that, having a grid on one of these would be super useful. So I thought, hey, I wonder if I can make one of these things just from the stuff around kicking around my house. The ones that I have really weird measurements to begin with. I wasn't finding anything that I could buy that would be particularly useful, at least not something that was just going to be temporary or affordable. So I headed on down to the old dollar store to grab a few things to fashion one myself. I ended up having most of the stuff at home, and I'm pretty sure most people would if you're a DIYer. The only thing that really cost me anything was a few sheets of poster board, which is like $2, so all I really needed to make this work otherwise was an old Amazon box, some scissors, the box cutter, measuring tape, ruler, hot glue gun, and some tape. I started out by measuring the width and the height of the softbox face to see the area that I'd need to cover, and then I found an old Amazon box that was wider than my largest measurement on the face. In this case, I think my face was 27.5 inches and my box was close to 28 or so. So I cut the Amazon box into 4 2-inch wide strips, and then I cut them down to the same width and height of the softbox, but on the two shorter strips, I left a few extra inches to make some little tabs, just so I had a surface to glue all the pieces together into a frame. Now, I glued the frame together with some hot glue, and then I just quickly checked the fit on the softbox. And then I got into the more tedious part of this, which was actually making the grid. I wanted my grid 2 inches tall, and I wanted my grid to be filled with 2-inch squares, so for me that meant I needed 13 horizontal strips and 9 vertical ones. I measured everything out into 2-inch tall strips on the poster board. The horizontal strips are shorter, so I cut those an extra 2 inches longer than the width of the frame, just to make tabs on each strip. And the others, I just had to cut to the same length of the softbox because there wasn't enough material for me to make tabs, which was totally fine because I just used my old friend, the hot glue gun, for this after. Once all my strips were measured and cut, I took my leftover poster board and I glued it to the inside of the box frame. Ideally, any part of that grid that comes into contact with light should be black or at least very dark so it's absorbing all that light and it's not reflecting it and bouncing it all over. I could have painted this black as well, but I had the extra material and it made my old Amazon box a little more sturdy. Then I made a mark every 2 inches on the inside of the frame so I knew where my grid was going to go. Back to the strips, I marked the tabs 1 inch in on each side of the horizontal ones and bent those 90 degrees. And I also marked all the strips every 2 inches. I did have one end measurement on the long pieces and on the inside of the frame. That was only about 1.5 inches because I don't have an even height number on my softbox. I then cut halfway through the strips along each one of these markings. Next, I started gluing in all my pieces with the tabs, lining up the markings, and making sure all the cuts that I made that go halfway through were facing up. Once those were all in, I slid in my vertical pieces with the 1/2-inch slits facing downwards, and then just gently lined up and fit all those slits facing up and down together, which creates the 2-inch grid. The only thing that I had to be careful of here was just to make sure that the last measurement on the end was always in the same place as it was a little bit shorter than 2 inches. So from there, I just used hot glue to fasten the ends that weren't attached to the frame, and boom, the frame was done. My next step was attaching this to the softbox. Now, you could probably do this in multiple ways. In my case, this isn't something that I'm planning on using long term. I keep these lights just kicking around my basement and they never leave the house. So all I ended up doing was using this stretchy medical tape that I had kicking around, just going along the edges. But I'm sure I could have used any other type of tape. It doesn't really have to be crazy strong or anything. The frame is pretty light. If I wanted, I could have went a step further and glued some tabs on here and made some holes through there and ran a string or a shoelace or something and cinched everything up on the back just so it would stay on. And then I could remove it after, but again, this isn't a long-term solution. We're literally dealing with paper materials here, so it's not going to be something that's very durable. But the question is, does this work? Let's test it out. Alright, so as you can see, it is pretty impressive just for a few dollars. I'm sure if you wanted to improve this, it really wouldn't be that hard. It is pretty tedious. It took me a couple of hours just to do all the work with the strips, cutting them and fitting them all together. But it was actually pretty fun to do it. If you guys have any questions at all about how I built this, leave them down below. Help out my channel by hitting that like button and help me out even more by subscribing. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again in the next video. See ya.